Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin. Welcome back to the Nao Nails channel. I hope you are coming back. That means I hope you've watched previous videos as well, because that would be pretty cool. If you could do that, please. Thanks very much. Not begging for subscribers, honest. Well, it does help us. It keeps us in a job, doesn't it? So,
yeah, it does, yeah.
So that's good.
Keeps it. You'll be able to buy another big bag of tea.
Yeah, I'll even buy a big bag of tea bags again. Yes, Yorkshire tea. Today we're gonna do some snake skin, and it's a different way of doing snake skin. Oh, we've done so many different ways of doing snake skin, but this is just another way that I think looks pretty cool. So yeah, we're gonna crack on and do it. So we're going to do two different versions, because you know I like to give you options, lots of options. The colours we're going to use today are from the new Diamond Dust collection. So we've got Apple of Your Eye, Twilight Amethyst, and Caribbean Nights. Well, Caribbean Night, there's no S on the end. So those are the colours. I love these colours, and they are really, really glittery. So obviously, well, I'm going to love them, aren't I? What I'm going to do first of all, let me just move that palette out of the way. We're going to apply a couple of coats, but I'm just going to do like a bit of a mishmash of these colours. You do need to make sure you sort of overlap with your second coat directly over the top of the colour, because you can see you will have a little bit of transparency, and we want to sort of hide that, really get away from that. We want it to be quite a solid colour. Obviously this is a clear tip. Now if you're doing it over the top of a acrylic nail extension, and if you've got underneath that, you could possibly have natural beige colour. You could maybe get away with one coat, but because I'm using a clear tip, then we do need to make sure we do the two coats so we get the true colour. So I'm just going to put them in random places. I am working sort of down the nail, so I'm not working horizontally. I don't want to widen the nail. Whenever you do a design that's horizontal, it will naturally want to widen the nail. Kind of that. Is it an optical illusion?
Yeah, it's like if you do stripes across, it makes you look wider.
Yeah.
Like stripey jumpers, yeah.
Yeah, stripey jumpers are never, you know, they have, the stripes have to go down. Yeah, but he isn't. I love black and white stripes, though. I absolutely love black and white stripes. So I can pop that one in, ready to put the lamp on. Let's do this one. I love this turquoise. My mum is a fan of this as well. Oh, she's pretty obsessed with turquoise. She owns that many belongings, you know, clothing and everything that are turquoise. Right, so you can see the gorgeous colours. We're going to pop that in the lamp and give that a blast. So I'm going in with the second coat of colour, going directly over those colours again. Now at this point, it doesn't matter if you merge them together, because that kind of looks cool. So if you sort of sweep over the colour that you've just laid down, that's fine, but make sure you just wipe off the tip of the brush before you put it back into the bottle, because you don't want to sort of mix that colour into your, you know, your bottle, because that would not be very good. So we're going to do that with both of the nails.
Ooh, somebody's just asked a question that I've never thought of on the in the comment section of a video.
Yeah, come on.
Can you mix monomers to get your perfect setting time?
Well, it's something I've never done. I've never needed to, really. I kind of feel that the setting times that we have like a variety. But if, I don't know, maybe we should give it a go one day.
And do tests.
Yeah. Right. So what we're going to do now is we're going to matte top coat one of them, obviously. And we're going to top coat in the Urban Graffiti top coat on the other one. So let's go with the shiny on this one. So this design's something that's really salon viable. It doesn't take too long, doesn't take too much skill. We want quick things for the salon, obviously. So I know like some designs that are way out there, you know, can not be really salon viable because they take too long. pop them in the lamp. Right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to get the top coat. And we're going to pop a little bit onto my palette. You'll only be able to see it because obviously it's shiny, so you can see the shine, but it's clear on a black surface, so that's, you know, hard to see. Right, so we're going to go into the matte dot and then go side to side, and then another one. Leave a gap between each of your little sort of oblong shapes, and if you can't see them very well, just rotate and rock the nail like this so you can see the shine of that wet product. We're going to go all the way down the center till we reach the bottom, and then to the side we're going to do smaller little sort of oblongy shapes. Don't worry about them being in line with each other. Then we're going to go and do some tiny little ones towards the edge. Then let's pop that in the lamp. Now on this one, we're going to do the opposite. So we're going to come in with the shiny Urban Graffiti top coat. This will be easier to see because we've got a matte background. So you're able to see exactly where you're putting your little shapes, the little scale shapes. You know, I was saying they don't need to be perfect, so there's not a massive amount of skill involved. And the little ones at the side. And we'll cure that. So if you look at the matte one, the matte on the shiny, you get that cool effect. You don't need to top coat it or anything like that because we're already working with top coat. We've already sealed it with the shiny top coat.
That's really interesting.
It's cool, isn't it?
Even watching through Zoom, it's very interesting.
Ooh. And it doesn't take a massive amount of skill. And I do think that the colours that you choose in the background make it pop. And then we've got the shiny version. So you've got two versions there. And I think they both equally look really cool.
Yeah, I like it.
And you could do any colour really, because snakes come in lots of different colours.
They certainly do.
But I think what I really like is the matte over the top of the glitter. How it like goes to that, it dulls the glitter, but then you've got the shiny which brightens the glitter. I think it looks really cool.
Dulls it, you've still got the texture and the depth.
Yeah. Cool. And then like you could do a couple of nails like that, and then the other nails could just be the solid colours that we chose for the background. They could either be matte or you could obviously do them shiny as well. So there we are. Hope you like them.
Is that it?
That's it.
Wow.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Salon viable nail art. Perfect.
Efficient filming as well. Well done.
Definitely efficient filming. So there we are, guys. If you want to know what I used, all the different products, they will be listed below in the description box. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Please keep watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
That around because I'm talking to the screen.